Warning. Tonight's show includes high-intensity strobe lights, flame effects, and pyrotechnical devices, which generate smoke and loud noises. If you are sensitive to any of these effects, please step to the concourse until after the opening ceremonies. We hope you enjoy tonight's presentation.
We're lapping out here digging a hole. And the madder I get, the deeper I go. Maybe you're thinking I'm a fool. Well, maybe I'm digging this hole for you. I got bones to pick with you. I should have known you can't be true. Me and the devil, we want what's due. And you should know. Is it true? Are you a bull rider on the PBR Built Ford Tough Series?
Yes, sir. This is by far the toughest 8 seconds in sports. Even been to the World Finals a few times in Vegas.
Okay, let me ask you this. Have you ever been scared? You ever feared getting on the back of that 2,000-pound bovine?
No, sir.
Are you lying to me? Aren't you scared of the kiddie rides at the local county fair? What about swimming? Do you venture to the deep end? And you call yourself a cowboy? Hey there. Hope things are peachy.
Sir?
Is it true that you are born and raised in Brazil?
Sim, eu sou de São Paulo, é na América do Sul, velho louco.
Don't you speak English?
No.
Is it true that you are a PBR world champion?
Sim, eu sou o melhor peão do mundo. Talvez te deixe limpar as barracas do meu cavalo na minha casa em Texas. Então você pode varrer o chão com as minhas... com as suas sobrancelhas.
Deixa-me dizer-lhe algo maluco coloca. Seu rosto entre as narinas. Cavalo, prepara-se. Dar-lhe beijão. Pegue as suas botas roças. E vai jogar. Amare linha com sua sobrinha. Don't even look my direction.
Yes, sir.
You a cowboy or a bull rider?
Both.
You don't say. So when'd you get started?
When I was a little kid. Now I'm one of the best bull riders in the world.
Oh, for crying out loud. I've heard about all I can stand for one day. Gentlemen, this is the PBR. This is a sport, not a game. There are no timeouts. There are no mercy rules, sweetheart. What are you looking at? There's just a one-ton horn freight train, and you guys who are crazy enough to try and ride him for 8 seconds. So unless you woke up this morning to a hearty bowl of warm soy milk and cinnamon pansy flakes, get off your adrenaline-starved tuckus and get your cowboy on!
Yeah.
Anaheim. Welcome to the toughest sport on earth. This is the one.
What do you say, California? Please welcome the Cowboys. Let's go. Columbia Falls, Montana's Matt Triplett.
From Oklahoma, it's LJ Jenkins.
From Australia, Jared Farley.
Show me Texas and Jason Malone.
From Santa Fe, Texas, Zach Brown.
This is the dancing Australian, Ben Jones.
Please welcome the talent from Arkansas, Reese Cates.
He comes to us from New South Wales, Australia, Troy Wilkinson.
Show me the money, Missouri, Luke Snyder.
It's Gresford, New South Wales, Lachlan Richardson.
Please welcome the talent from Brazil, Eduardo Aparecido.
He is the Brazilian talent named Emilio Resende.
Another talent from South America, this is João Ricardo Vieira.
He is the 2010 world champ, Renato Nunes.
From Decatur, Texas, Brant Atwood.
How about Arkansas's Chase Outlaw?
From Brazil, this is Edivaldo Ferreira.
The wily veteran from Morpeth, New South Wales, Brendan Clark.
How about the talent from Canada? We welcome Ty Pazabon.
On his way up from North Dakota, it's Nathan Shopper.
Say hello to the 2009 PBR World Champ, Cody Lostro.
From Sao Paulo, Brazil, Marco Agushi.
Man from Paris, Tennessee, Cody Nance.
Say hey to Virginia's Billy Robinson.
We move to Brazil's Ignaldo Cardoso.
The 2004 world champion, Mike Lee.
Whooping it up from Longmont, Colorado, Jory Marcus.
How about the 2008 world champ, Guilherme Marchi?
The talent from Canada, this is Aaron Roy.
They call him Double D from Texas, Douglas Duncan.
They are the world's best. It's time to meet the top five bull riders of the PBR.
We begin with a man in the five spot from Somerville, Georgia. Yeah.
He is in the number four position from Stephenville, Texas. It's Jordan Hupp.
He is a PBR fan favorite from Mooresville, North Carolina. Say hello to J.B. Mooney.
Also from the great state of North Carolina, hot on the heels of world number one, is this guy. Say hello to the number two ranked bull rider, Shane Proctor.
The big screen says it all. The man hoisting that cup above his head did it once, but then again, to make it two times, back to back, the champ, say hello, center stage, Silvano Alves.
Folks, they are the very best in the business. Three men that will put their lives on the line for the top 35 bull riders in the world. It's time to meet your Dickies Durable Fighters.
The first one comes to us from north of the border up Canada way. Would you please?
He is known as the Fearless One from Oklahoma. It's Frank Newton.
He may hang his hat in the Lone Star State of Texas, but he is a native Californian. Would you please welcome Mr. Short?
Southern California. Oh, that's right. There's one more. One more, the exclusive entertainer of the PBR. Would you give it up for my man from Montana? It's Flint Rasmus. Well, last weekend, the top 35 bull riders in the world went to battle in Sacramento. And when the dust settled in Northern California, Guilherme Marchi bested the field to capture to win. Tonight, he will get on this bull. Rewarded with the opportunity on this bull called Sancho, Marchi will go head-to-head with this bull for 8 seconds with one more chance to capture glory and one more chance to get closer to $1 million. And it'll all happen tonight. Not only for the money, but hopefully to get closer to a world championship title. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this time I'd like to ask if you'd please stand and remove cover for our invocation to be followed by the singing of our national anthem. Let us pray. Father, tonight we come to you, thankful of the opportunity to be here and watch and witness such an incredible sport. We ask that your hand of guidance be with our cowboys, but not only them, we'd ask that you be with our livestock as well. We thank you for this day. We thank you for the gifts you've given us. We'd like to say a very special prayer for our service men and women. May they be here at home or even abroad, protecting and defending the freedoms that we so dearly love as free Americans. We ask these things in forgiveness of our sins. In your mighty name we pray. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, this next young lady is traveling the great United States, singing in all 50 states to promote patriotism and honor our nation's heroes. To sing tonight's national anthem, please welcome the very lovely and talented voice of Miss Janine Stang.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming in the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free? And the
California, listen. I think it's time to get some lights on in this place, and we're going to need your help. I want you to count it down with me at 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
Turn all the lights on.
Well, here we go. Round number 2 on its way. How we doing, California, on a Saturday night? Oh, well, there it is. Of course, welcome you all here tonight. The LiftMaster Invitational on its way. I am Clint Atkins alongside my colleague, my left, Mr. Brandon Bates. Well, Brandon, here we go. Round 1 is in the book. 17 qualified rides last night, and we have got a great lineup coming to you in round number 2.
Look, the guys last night turned it on. As you talk about what they were able to do in round number 1, but it didn't come without a price. We saw some big-name guys get banged up in there. Most notably, that's got to go to J.B. Mooney. We don't know. He may be competing with a fractured bone in his leg after being stepped on. You're going to get to see that right here. Actually, that was in the chute when he got posted back. Now, this is after that. This is his final competition, his ride last night. You watch him get stepped on right there. And so you're looking at that right leg. That's the area for concern when it comes to JB. We'll be talking about with him, but it should be a great night of bull riding.
Well, absolutely. And Dr. Tandy Freeman posted the injury report for JB Mooney. As you mentioned, possible broken bone in that leg. He will ride tonight, and that is a fact. You will see JB Mooney riding here on a Saturday night. Lots of things to talk about. Guilherme Marchi, he will also get on his bonus bull tonight.
Well, that's right. Look, he's going to be competing for a pile of money. Not only that, points. That's the big thing with this bonus round. Remember, points right now, the money is just kind of a bonus in the PBR. Points are king. That's what wins you a world championship, and now that's what also gets you to the world final. So you got to have it. We'll explain all of that to you tonight. It's going to be a good one.
Well, talking about getting to places, listen, let's rewind, get you caught up for what's going on the PBR Built for Tough Series. It's time to take a look at previously on the PBR.
Previously on the PBR, the world's toughest cowboys headed west to Sacramento, California. Last year's champion, Silvano Alves, continued to stay on top of the world standings, while the Carolina Cowboys, J.B. Mooney and Shane Proctor, stay hot and hungry on his tracks. PBR stars Austin Meyer and Ryan Dirteater, two of the regulars on the tour, miss the first cut of the season and will have to earn their way back to the Built for Tough stage. However, Australian Brendan Clark, who announced this will be his final year on the tour, landed a top 5 finish to avoid being cut. American Cody Lostro split a win on the PBR 1515 bucking battle, while Bull of the Year Asteroid continues to prove he's tougher than any man can handle. And after a pair of top 10 finishes, including a win in Sacramento, 2008 world champion Guilherme Marchi is back on track and in the top 10 of the standings. It's week 6 on the Built for Tough Series. This is bull riding. This is the PBR.
Here we go, folks. Take a look up at the big screen right there. There is your Jack Daniels average leaderboard. Ignaldo Cardozo on top. Renato Nunes hot on his heels at 88.5 points. Brendan Clark, Reese Cates in double D, Douglas Duncan rounding out the top 5. And, of course, want to welcome once again everybody here to LiftMaster Invitational round number 2 on its way. And, of course, Want to welcome everybody that is listening and watching at home on our PBR Live Event Center. And, of course, right now we are on the air, speaking of live, on CBS Sports Network right now with our Pure PBR show. And, Brandon, it's going to be a great night. Now, we look up there at the points talking about we're a long ways away from Las Vegas. We're a long ways from crowning that world champion and that million-dollar bonus. But I got to tell you something. Every ride, every point is absolutely critical, and this is a big night in a long marathon weekend.
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of things to talk about. You can go back and you can look at what guys are going to do with these regular season events, and you can even say that, you know, two or three buck-offs in the regular season, quite possibly even one buck-off in the regular season, depending on where it comes, may cost you a world title. It is that crucial. It would be the same analogy as saying that, you know, a team that loses in the NFL, their first game of the season, that may be the game that cost them to miss the playoffs. My point is, every moment in this sport at this level, the Built Ford Tough Series, is critical. Every time you nod your head, you got to get there and do everything you can to make the whistle because, look, you know, second chances, they're slim and none in this sport.
Well, it's been a lot of buildup to get here to round number two, and I know the guys back there are anxious and ready to get inside of the Buck and Shoots. And, folks, you can see a lot of activity starting to happen in front of the Jack Daniels Buck and Shoot. They are huddling, and it is time to make it happen. SoCal, you ready for the PBR? What do you say?
Well, and in the action we go, we will start fast and furious in this first section of competition. Take a look. Jack Daniels Shoots, where we're going to go and get started with. Cody Lostro will be the first cowboy. The talent from Longmont, Colorado, 2009 world champ, Maximum Justice. The bull from Jeff Robinson, Bucking Bulls, got just a good one underneath him right now. He needs a good one. And the reason I say that is because Cody Lostro last night down before the 8 seconds, so he's got a little work, a little ground to make up.
Yeah, he did. You know, Cody Lostro came out of the shoot in New York City, Brandon, and posted a top five finish. We all said, hey, the old Cody Lostro is back. He's been dealing with a lot of injuries over the last couple of seasons. That hand still bothering him. You can see him. We saw it last weekend in Sacramento when he got off his bull and he's holding that riding hand. So dealing with that injury, but you know what? It's like everything else. All 35 of these guys are dealing with some pain.
Well, that's exactly right. Everybody's got something to deal with at this level. Everybody's beaten, battered, and bruised, even though we're only at stop number 6. Very few guys have something that, you know, you can't go in there and mash on it. It's going to hurt them. Cody right now taking a little extra time, making sure it's just right. He is. Let's go. Started off big time on a Saturday night. He does his job off on his feet. Bullfighter steps in. That is picture perfect, folks.
Yeah, fantastic. And awaiting the numbers coming in. Watch it back on the replay. Hard to find a fault in this ride. And 86.5 points. 86.5. And Brandon, I'm going to go to you with a question as we get ready for our next bull rider. I mean, he bucked off last night. He got some numbers tonight. Where does that put him in this whole marathon? I mean, 3 rounds plus a championship round. And where does that put Cody right now?
He just needs to step up and do his job tomorrow. That's going to be the big day for him. He's got to ride a bull tomorrow, find out what happens on Sunday. But the 86.5 is definitely going to help Cody Lostro right there. Now, let's take a look. Matt Triplett, this is a young man from Columbia Falls, Montana, coming here by way of winning an event on the Touring Pro Division in Eugene, Oregon. He did that last week. Out of all the new guys bouncing in from the Touring Pro wins and so on, a lot of you watching Live Event Center know exactly what I'm talking about. This guy has probably been the most impressive.
Yeah,
to just bust out of there. Come from Columbia Falls, Montana, say I'm ready for the big leagues.
Right, and Matt Triplett has looked like a veteran. How does he handle this?
And that is simply a bull that in that trip, in that situation, should not have bucked him off.
Right.
He's expecting this bull to jump out there and turn back, trying to go to the right just as fast as he can, but he thought it was going to happen any second, but it just never did. And the bull kind of hopping, leaping, and I mean, just point blank, Matt knows it out. Mm. He knows I'd say this to him. That's not at this level.
Right.
That's a bull that shouldn't buck you.
Well, that's going to put the pressure on Matt tomorrow. I mean, he with the score from last night, he's gonna have to step up on a Sunday to get in that championship round. So, Agnaldo Cardozo. Maverick, humps and horns, and sis and Stan bucking bulls in the Stanley bucking shoot. And if my memory is correct, this bull and Frank Newsom last weekend, this is the bull that knocked Frank Newsom out in Sacramento, California. By the way, I know we've got the video of that.
Your memory may be correct. Right. It may be better. I don't know. If we have that video of last weekend in Frank's wreck, we'll see if we take a look at it. I don't know if we have time. We may.
Well, he is the 27-year-old getting ready. Yeah, this was last week. This is this same bull you're about to see.
Yeah, so Frank. Frank's down there, though. However, you see Frank in the tan shirt down there just away from the buck and shoot. Right now, the guys are probably – there may be a little revenge. A little revenge going on in there. And Frank's thinking, it's like, yeah, it's not going to happen this time. Agnaldo Cardozo on the Maverick.
Starting to get things put together. A couple of top 10 finishes. Yup. Look out, Frank! No!
What is up?
Are you serious?
Really?
Come on, man!
What?
Well,
look at Frank Newsom. Yeah, he is staring that bull down.
Oh. He is not happy. He moves in right here and saves Agnaldo. Look, number one, don't forget, point blank, there are three guys down there, and their job is to save the cowboy
at
all costs. And I'm going to tell you right now that that's exactly, as you watch this back, big screen, take a look, that is exactly what he does. I mean, he took that bull clearly away from Agnaldo.
Hey. Flint, get down here.
That's brilliant. Waving your hat through the fence. That's awesome. There you go.
Yeah.
I'm out.
Up the fence.
Oh, go ahead.
Andy Watson up the fence.
That'll show him.
Yeah.
He just wanted to make it on his terms.
There you go. Exactly.
I gotta
say something right now. They're down there. There's a shot of Frank Newsom. After getting knocked out, getting the stitches from that same bull last weekend, he came back to the event and worked the night after that. Frank Newsom, one of the toughest men on the face of the planet. There you go.
LJ Jenkins, California kid, humps and horns. Oh, you are kidding me. 7.96. And he may go.
I think he's going to challenge this.
Yep.
There it is. And Brandon, let's talk about this. I mean, this is a logical move for him. Being that close right there, LJ Jenkins, who turned in the 85.5 points, and we're not done front of the chutes.
He may get the nod here, too, because, look, he keeps his hand in that rope all the way to the ground. And they're going to take a look at it there.
Did he have any part of that bull rope in his hand
still
in 8 seconds
it.
Before he disqualifies himself or hits the ground?
No. So, whoopee, see, yeah, there it is. No score coming in for LJ Jenkins. It is a no score. Tough luck for him.
Wow.
Unfortunately, down a little bit early.
All right. So, let's check our Jack Daniels average leaderboard. Agnaldo Cardozo, still the number one man, the only man to ride to. 170 and a quarter so far.
Tonight's thrills are made possible by the 2013 Ford F-150 with EcoBoost. Carries on the built Ford tough tradition. You don't have to sacrifice power for fuel efficiency. With EcoBoost, you can have both. To see how you can win one, go to Clash of the Cowboys.com. Las Vegas, proud home of the PBR built Ford tough world.
20 years of thrills. 20 years of spills. 20 years of excitement that only the PBR could deliver. Come celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Professional Bull Riders as the Built Ford Tough Series returns to Sprint Center February 23rd and 24th for the Built Ford Tough Invitational. Presented by Ford F-150 with EcoBoost. Tickets start at just $10. Get them now at AXS.com. Buckle up, Kansas City.
Listen, if you want to make your way to the Ariat booth up on the concourse, sign up, and if your name is drawn out, the good folks at Ariat are going to give you an opportunity to get your boots dirty.
Get them dirty.
Exactly. Check out the brand new line of Western boots from our friends at Ariat, the official boot of the PBR. Speaking of cool things going on.
Yeah, I'm right
here. Good folks at Fortnite. Pretty quick. That's right. If you want to get closer to tonight's action, Ford Trucks and Clash of the Cowboys want to send you to the shark cage, that thing right there.
Right here.
Exactly.
Inside it, not on top of it.
Right.
No. This inside, is my space inside. Right here.
Right. Exactly.
My space. There's a blast from the past. Go ahead. Finish.
Hey.
Go ahead.
Tweet us at Clash Cowboys for your chance to win a seat upgrade. That's right. Just let us know where you're at, your seat location. Tell us your section, your row, your seat number. We want to hear from you.
And while you're at it, follow at PBR on Twitter.
Right.
Follow us on Facebook. Duh, of course.
Exactly.
Duh.
I mean, who's not on Facebook?
Yeah, who isn't on Facebook besides you and you?
Yeah, I'm not on.
I'm not. That's not entirely true. I am. I have an account that I never go to.
I am on Facebook, and randomly throughout the week, pretty much once a day, I take a picture of myself in my bathroom with duck face and post it on my Facebook page.
Right. You and every other female around the world.
Me and every other 17-year-old girl who's in love with themselves.
Yes.
Can I get a shot? Here it is. Where's my camera? Where am I right? Why don't I see him? Where? Oh. Here it is. Ready? Here's my imitation of a 17-year-old girl on Facebook. Did I hear? What did you just play? What did you, Mark?
Yo, VIP. Let's kick it.
We got to get warmed up. It's Saturday. You know it? I know it. All right, stop. Collaborate and listen. Ice is back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a harpoon daily and nightly. Will it ever stop? Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage, wax a chump like a candle.
Dance. Crush a speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly.
Nice.
Oh, take me back. Take me back, old school.
We are on a journey.
Yes.
Grab on.
We're on a journey. Grab.
Brant Atwood, Decatur, Texas. The 25-year-old has got a bull called Super Cool Cat in the Las Vegas Buck and Shoot. Big finish in Oklahoma City. Is not out of a full season on the Built Ford Tough Series. Looking for points. It's Super Cool Cat bringing it. Oh, getting Shorty Gorham.
Got him.
Lined out.
Frank, no.
Nope. Frank.
Frank, no. I got him. Got him. Saving lives. It's what I do.
You kidding? My goodness. What are we going to do with you? Well, you see that bull dropping him down in there in 43 and a half points. Our Pabst Blue Ribbon bull score. Something we're going to keep an eye on here this evening.
The video tease tells the story. It is Luke Snyder setting inside of the Las Vegas shoe. The man from Raymore, Missouri. Right now, look, last night had a pretty good one. 86 and three quarter points. Not a bad night at all for Luke Snyder. He was 29th. He needed the points. He had to move up a little bit. He's got the bull back door from Humps and Horns, Sis and Stans, Buck and Bulls. I don't know exactly what's going to happen right now, what we're going to see when they open the gate, but I will tell you this. The bulls that we saw from Humps and Horns, Sis and Stans last week in Sacramento, this set, this particular bull, one of them, very impressive.
Yeah, they've done a lot of work out here at California Stock Contractors, and they have looked mighty good so far. The Bass Pro Shops bull rider, Luke Snyder, getting ready to go. Can he challenge Ignaldo Cardozo, who is on top right now?
See, my life is not complete. I'll never see you smile. Try, let it ride. Maybe you want the forgiving kind, and that's just not my style.
There it is, Luke Snyder. Nice, and awaiting the numbers coming in. You watch the replay. Back right here. How about 86 points? 86. And that will be enough to catapult him into the number one position in the average. 172 and three quarter points, Luke Snyder, the number one man here at the LiftMaster Invitational. Nice ride. Let's go to the Jack Daniels Buck and Shoot. And how impressed have you been with Nathan Chopper?
Nathan Chopper, another one of the young guys that you got to really pay attention to. Big tall kid, Grassy Butte, North Dakota, 6 foot tall, or even, I think he's a little taller than that. They may have shorted him a little. Wolf Pup, the bull from Humps and Horns. Only saw this bull once last week. Man, he just makes great moves and very few mistakes. And when he gets in a situation where he's forced to make a move, he makes the right one.
Right, and you can watch his back right here. And, you know, this bull didn't have a whole lot of kick right there. Really had to work that free arm right there. Got the eight. Not going to be a whole lot of points. Of course, we pointed that out. Bull didn't have a lot of kick. Your judges looking for that. Remember the score. Half for the bull, half for the bull rider. 82 and three-quarter points for Nathan Chopper. Good news is he's got some numbers on the board.
João Ricardo Vieira, Stanley Shute.
Wow.
Kid might be the real deal.
Yeah, you are. You know, I mean,
that bull is really hard to ride.
And, you know, he did that last night on his bull, and you see him working that outside foot. And Mr. Vieira, 82 and a half points. This is going to get him two on the scoreboard, 169. That right there will put him third in the average.
We couldn't do this without our partners, LiftMaster, rugged gate operators, and garage door openers that are built.
Everyone is talking about Bushwhacker.
He really and truly don't really care much for people.
Bushwhacker, he'll stand in that shoe like a show calf, and you can definitely tell you're not intimidating him at all.
Bushwhacker really climbs in that front end and really gets way up high off the ground.
His front feet hit, and he already starts his next jump while his hind feet are still this high off the ground.
He just gets higher with every jump and a little stronger.
Bushwhacker is the rankest bull I've ever put my bull rope on. I've been riding professionally for 12 years in the PBR.
I think the moment that got the world's attention on Bushwhacker is when he slung J.B. Mooney in there like a rag doll.
You want to see explosive?
Holy cow.
You know, a lot of guys don't want to get on them bulls, but the way I look at it is, who remembers 85-point bull rides?
Last year, Austin Meyer rode Bushwhacker. This year, J.B. Mooney.
And it's all right in front of him right now.
Ever so close. Mooney is your iron cowboy, but he was 7/10 of a second away from setting Cowboy Stadium on fire. It's the fourth time they've met. It's the fourth time Bushwacker has won, but this time Bushwacker helps JB to an infamous title.
Hi, how you doing? Nice to see you. Good to see you. I see you. Hello, Brad. Here, face this way. Look it up on the big screen. There you are. I know. Brad, let me tell you something. It takes a while to get used to how cool you look on the big screen. It took me a long time. Long time. Hey, Brad, how old are you? You're six? You're tall. Hey, look, who just told him that? Some guy. Stick your chest out. So you're six. Where do you live? Where are you from?
Chino.
Cool. Little guy getting invaded. It's the baby from those commercials that talks. It's a little creepy. So what grade are you in? First grade? Really? You like school? What's your favorite subject? Recess? Girls? Math. Yes. So here's the deal. You're my best dressed cowboy. You got your Wrangler jeans. You got your Wrangler shirt. You got your hat. You got your vest in case you got to get on a bull. Take this card. Go on the computer. Get yourself some more Wranglers. Because real cowboys wear Wranglers. Do you know why real cowboys wear Wranglers? Because we look really good in them. That's true. Then pack them in this Wrangler Long Live Cowboys duffel bag. Brad, you good? My man Brad. Best dress.
Thank you, buddy. Congratulations, our Wrangler. Best dressed cowboy.
Did you see my shadow?
Yeah.
Did you see him?
I see him.
Come down here. Hurry.
You better
here.
Hurry.
Come here.
Don't show your age.
Look at this. It's my shadow.
I see that.
That creeps me out a little bit. Good to see you.
Oh, getting ready. There they are.
Get him.
Nice.
Turn around. Turn around. Get him. Is that jazz hands?
Yes. Absolutely. Back into the action, Brandon. Let's go to Brendan. Brendan Clark, Morpeth, New South Wales, Australia.
Yeah, originally Morpeth, New South Wales, Australia. Has his tent set up in California. Pike is the name of the bull from Evan Matthews. This will be interesting right here. You see Brendan Clark's clock stop 2.9 seconds. The clock at 2.94. And
yeah, let's watch a replay back.
They got him for touching the bull with a free arm. Now, right. If he doesn't touch the challenge button, he knows it. And he's not touching the challenge button because he knows it. So it'll be a no score after last night's 87. That's got to be the most frustrating.
Yeah.
Because he really did just kind of graze him. Like he slapped him.
Yeah.
But he gets him right there in the front, top of that horn. And then there again, touches him with a forearm. And then finishes the ride out. That would have been two. And he knows it right now.
Yeah, disappointed after the scores last night. And Brendan Clark, once again, similar scenario a little while ago. It's going to put pressure on him to get a score on Sunday. As we climb inside the Stanley Buck and Shoot, Marco Agushi, the 23-year-old bull rider from Sao Paulo, Brazil. And how about the story on this young man?
Look, Marco Iguchi, you know, a kid from inside of the city. This is not your typical ranch, outdoors, I lived on a farm my whole life kind of talent. This is a guy that came from the city, had some buddies that rode bulls down in Brazil, and he picked up on that at a very young age and just carried it on. But now here he is, 23 years of age, and man, this kid is legit. He is here to stay, the real deal. And Marco Iguchi, as you watch High Time, the bull from Evan Matthews, just a great guy. Yeah, Marco Iguchi is going to eat that bull up.
What a guy. He's 23 years old in America on top of the world. And I got to tell you something else, Brandon. He's been working on his English. I mean, every week he goes home and he works on his English. He gets better and better. He's adapting to everything. 82 and three-quarter points. Good news is he's got some numbers on the board. He needed them.
He gave me the biggest air high five I've ever seen in my life. Did you see it?
No, actually.
Let's see
I
if they
it.
Keep it on him.
All right, we'll see.
Yeah. It's slow. Yeah. But he'll come over. Keep it going on him. Keep it going. I give him a little jab. He turns for the high five, and I am not there.
It happens.
I don't know why you had to do. Why'd you do that to him?
I love that. Cross him over. March it down. Hit the beat. You ready? Right here. Touchins against law. Looks like we got a lot of lawbreakers around here. So take your lies and all your things and take a ride back from where you came now.
Troy Wilkinson is a man, the New South Wales, Australia talent that is, you know, had a couple of stops now on the PBR's Billboard Tough Series. And
Man.
Don't.
2.06 seconds. I would give the pyro guy $1,000 if he just hit the switch right now and let the flames go off.
Low flame right here?
Right. He says,
oh,
no.
We're coming back. This is, we didn't finish. Oh. Ready? Ready, Clint? You're going to help us? Oh, you're singing too. And I could tell it wouldn't be long. With me. Here we go. Everybody, even you people.
Hey.
It's going to be a good night.
Saw Saturday night, I guarantee you. Nothing else like it. Hey, by the way, the man on the back of the horse right there from Oakdale, California, Mr. Julio Marino, everybody, by the way. Taking an opportunity right now as we are away at commercial on the CBS Sports Network.
Because we're live.
That's right, we're live. PBR Posse members, don't forget you receive 10% off PBR tickets when purchased with the PBR Visa. If you don't have a PBR Visa, stop by the concourse booth for more information. That's right.
Did you just say information?
Information, the 411, give it to me. Speaking of things that are going on tonight.
Yeah, just a second.
It's
Sam.
It's meat night.
It's meat, me, and the bullfighters
right,
night.
Exactly.
So I like to. I'm not afraid to sell this a little bit.
So, sell it.
Sell himself. It. He's selling himself.
I'm going to sell myself currently. Uh-huh. So if you're up on the concourse merchandise stand and you buy one of my replica jerseys, like the little kid that looks just like me on the top level right there,
or the bullfighters, or the bullfighters,
or the bullfighter jerseys, you get a little pass, a little lanyard.
Right.
And you get a little pass.
Uh-huh.
And you get to stand. We'll go. I don't know where it is.
I do. Section 201.
By up right behind Section 201.
Yep.
And we'll go up and sit at a table, and we'll sign your jersey. We'll sign this little deal, and we'll pretend we're friends, and it's awesome. So there you go.
There it is.
That's tonight after right the show.
Well, you gotta,
on the concourse.
Why you got to pretend?
Because there's a lot of people I don't know, so we act like we're friends.
Right.
Yeah. Like exactly. That guy right there. That guy. Dude, stand. Stand. Get off your phone. Wait a second.
Listen, has a problem with people on phones.
Wait a minute. Wait, he's still on his phone.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm doing a little presentation. I addressed you personally, which I don't do to a lot of people here. There's what, 12,000 people here? I addressed you personally. You looked up as if you were at dinner with your parents, not paying attention, and you kept texting. Who are you? What's the deal? What are you doing? Who are you texting? Your friend.
And you're upset because he wasn't paying attention to you.
Listen, when I'm talking, undivided attention right there.
Yep.
Don't be straying off texting your little girly. Okay? LOL, OMG.
You know what? What are we going to do with you?
No.
I mean, I just...
Hey.
The whole LOL, OMG thing,
exactly.
Like real guys don't do that. You just do that.
Me? I don't LOL.
Yeah, you do too.
Yes. Because I... Okay.
Smiley faces and stuff.
What is your name? Tyler, are you going to come up and wait in line and have me sign your jersey later? I'm not going to. No, I will. Tyler, I'll remember that. Tyler.
Tyler, you have my permission to punch him when you get
what?
Up there. Just
no. How old are you?
Right there, right hook.
How old are you? 15, which explains the texting.
Right.
Exactly. Kids do not have to actually talk to people anymore.
Right.
They're like right here. Hi,
yeah.
Nice beer.
Exactly. Folks, the Las Vegas Buck and Shoot is right now the home of a man that was born and raised in Orange County, California. Lived here, raised here, then moved to Hawaii, back to the States, and he is a professional bull rider, Zach Brown. On graffiti.
There you go, Zach Brown, going to deal it up. Struggled a little bit last night, had a rough go at it, but now here he is in graffiti.
Toeing
the
line.
The bull from Jerry Brown.
Absolutely.
He gets it done.
Absolutely. Toeing the line tonight, 86.25 points. And Zach Brown
on the board. I stared him down right here.
And what did that accomplish?
Entertainment
Throwing it down.
Entertainment value, my friend.
Okay.
Because really, if you think about it, what's any of this accomplishing, really?
Ty Pazabon, Merritt, Canada. About to roll out a little LL Cool J. You'll see. That's the name of the bull. I'm serious. LL Cool J. Built for a tough for a truck shoot, dealing it up for you. Ty Pazabon got one knocked out last night for 81.75 points. The big deal on Saturday is make it moving day. Make it count. Get two if you can and go with it.
That is what is on the clock in Ty Pazabon. What?
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on. I got him.
I wish he would jump up there with you.
Really?
Yeah.
That would be funny.
Move. Go that way. Bull, big green thing on top. Now. Little blue guy. Get him. Shorty, help me out here. Just throw him up there.
Uh-oh. This could be trouble.
Yeah, Julio Moreno said, okay, we've had enough of that.
Oh, crap. Now, was that necessary? What did that accomplish?
Well, you know, we've been through this before.
I know, and I'm moving.
Right.
So, do we have that? I think we should show the people why I am a little...
That's the reason why...
Why I'm a little leery.
Right. Right there.
Well, apparently you do play a good leprechaun.
Exactly.
Magically delicious.
Why do you gotta keep... Dude, like you...
And then here's what it's supposed to look like. Ready? Watch. Little white guy from Montana. Bam!
Nailed it.
I got some
hoppity. He's trying to tell me the other day, we were standing up here on the stage yesterday, and he said, you couldn't jump that high. I was like, if there was a rope running underneath me and a bull tied to it, I bet I could.
Right. Edivaldo Fajeda. Ready to go. JD. In the Jack Daniels bucking shoe.
Edivaldo. Getting ready to go. Let's think about it. We talked briefly about the free arm last night. Girl, I reckon. Been around the world and I've been chucking. Better listen close to this
redneckin'. Sitting on the front porch, do a little courting. Radio bumping. Stop, drop, roll. Stop, drop, roll. Frank, no. Come on, everybody, let's do some swing. There's a little girl in our neighborhood. Her name is Charlotte Johnson and she's really looking good. Had to go and see her, so I called her on the phone. Over to my house, and here's what's going on. I'm going with it.
I know, keep going.
Eating chocolate pie. Mama was in the kitchen cutting chicken up to fry. Daddy was in the backyard rolling up a garden hose. I was on the porch with Charlotte. Down to my toes, and we were swinging. That's a timeless classic.
Yeah, that you don't know the words
exactly.
To.
So we went to commercial. That's why I kept singing. And this is like my commercial. So
yes.
I wanted to. What I love to do when I'm here in California, especially Southern California, if you look at this crowd here in Southern California tonight, we have pretty much every demographic of people you could possibly imagine. You know what we are right here? You know what we are? We're diverse. Old, young, city people, country people. We got tweeners. We got people that love a little everything. Mark and I, Mark, raise your hand. Nope, he won't. He plays all the music, and we like to take 3 minutes every night here in Southern California to hit every demographic of people in that span of time to make everybody happy. Mark, let's do it. Watch out, Julio, I'm coming. Go.
I ain't nothing but a hound dog, the crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't another quarter rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. Well, they said you.
Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 Gangnam Style.
You don't know how to do it. You don't know it. You don't know it.
Hang it out.
I like my real thick, low mo tie.
You're pretty, oh so pretty. I feel pretty and witty and gay.
What?
And I
what? No. Here we go. Last dance.
So let's dance.
Give it up for Flint Rasmussen!
Romance tonight.
Hey. Listen. We had... You want to keep going?
Oh.
We got plenty of time.
I'm good. Let's go. You like that move?
That was good.
We're just friends. What are you saying?
Said there's another in the right in my eyes. My first love broke my heart for the first time. And I was like,
well, wow. Brandon, I, you know, I got to make it stop. Yeah. Listen, I do have to say we did shut it down. Yeah, there you go, Anna. We did shut it down maybe just a hair bit early because we were worried about your health just a little bit. I mean, honestly. All right? Did a great job.
Appreciate your love.
Give it to me, Bo. Give it to me. There it is.
Yeah.
All right, folks. Back into it. Show me the Jack Daniels average leaderboard right now. Luke Snyder on top. 172.75 points. He is your leader at the LiftMaster Invitational.
Well, take a look. Move you right now. Chase Outlaw. Be the man to go, Hamburg, Arkansas. How do you say that?
What?
How do you say that?
Say what?
That the name of the sport.
Chaparral.
Is it Chaparral?
Yeah.
Chaparral. I don't. Yeah.
What?
These bulls, some of these bulls. No. Some of the bulls now they need to come with like an explanation.
Right. Well, there is a website out there that you can Google and.
Really?
Yeah, it's got names all. I don't know why they're not looking at it.
I would have never known.
Yeah. I mean, everything. I mean, is on there, right?
Chase Outlaw. Hamburg, Arkansas, yeah. The man to go.
Now, 20 years old.
He got, you know, looking at Chase and what he was able to do. 85.75 points, that was last night.
Guess who is knocking on the door? Guess who is knocking on the door? Guess who is knocking.
Kid's no doubt the real
the
deal.
Door.
Many people had counted him to be last year's Rookie of the Year, and then Emilio Resende came to Las Vegas and said, I'm that guy.
Yeah, he did overtake him at the end of the season. Chase Outlaw, after starting out really hot in New York City at Madison Square Garden, he has struggled 4 weeks in a row. Chase Outlaw had extensive conversation with him yesterday. He talked about making adjustments this week, and Brandon, he did last night get the score. Now he's got to put two together.
Outlaw.
And they're a great shot. Brandon looking down inside there. He is
trying to get that bull to pick his head up. Yep. So there he is right now. If he's set, that bull's there he goes.
Oh!
Man, it just pulled him down in there, Frankie!
Whoop, whoop, whoop. My back. Yeah, fence is harder to climb than it looks. Hey, 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 bam, hey.
What? I mean, really?
Really? I'm just trying to create some sort of
entertainment.
That was a tough one.
That was
Bam. Nailed him right in stride.
Yeah, that was a tough one. Things that weigh a ton typically are very difficult to hit when they're 2 feet away.
Could Tebow have made that throw? No.
Probably. Sanchez would be more in question.
Look at my hat. I butt fumbled it.
You guys. Come on.
What?
Lachlan Richardson.
If I was your boyfriend, I'd never let you go. I could take you places you ain't never been.
So we went from Chase Outlaw, the 20-year-old bull rider from Arkansas, to another 20-year-old bull rider. The Aussie talent, Lachlan Richardson, and ride this one. Oh, no, boy.
Yeah.
Rough weekend so far from Lachlan.
The White Wolf. Very rare. But
right.
Handily.
Right.
Taken. So nobody got that. I know. No one picked up.
The folks at home on Live
Event Center. The folks at home
with
the Live Event Center got that.
What, the White Wolf?
The White Wolf. Extremely rare.
Yes.
Very sneaky.
The people in Montana right now listening are saying not that rare.
They're barely floating along the edges of Yellowstone National Park.
Yes. Rarely seen.
You guys. All right. You guys. All right, so 8 qualified rides so far. Jason Malone.
I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in
taking his rap in the Stanley Chute. Cybercats, Circle T, and 3B Bucking Bulls. Well, he is here as an alternate this weekend, Brandon. 35 guys to get to compete on the Built for Tough Series every week. There are some to get injured. They go home. They're on the injured reserve list. Jason Malone got called up from the minor leagues. You're in the big show this week. Got to make the most of it.
Yeah.
Let me tell you a little story about how I was raised. Every day work, every day pray. God, family, friends. Yeah.
Right there on the ribs when a bull does that, it's just not fun. Oh, picked him up midair. How you doing? You're almost going to get to touch the ground, but not quite. Watch it again.
One more time, huh?
I like it. It's wow.
Jason Malone, he needs a little bit of pick-me-up right now. So, Cal, what do you say? Make him feel a little bit better. There he is. So our Jack Daniels high-marked ride so far in round number two goes to Cody Lostro. 86.5 points. Congratulations to you, Cody, from our friends at Jack Daniels.
Hey, this heart-stopping action is brought to you by Wrangler. Long live Cowboys. Yeti.
Here's this week's athlete profile brought to you by Cooper Tires.
To win a PBR event is a very joyous experience. Everybody comes here with that idea, but the reality is much more difficult. It's not easy here in the United States, and I don't speak English very well. But one thing is similar, to win an event is very gratifying. It's new and different. The satisfaction is enormous. At this level of the PBR, there are so many excellent riders, Brazilians, Americans, Australians. For me, winning provoked a unique emotion.
Fabiano Vieira, able to put a final exclamation point on a weekend to remember.
Here's this week's athlete profile brought to you by Cooper Tires.
We are like brothers. We are together every week at the event and in our homes. Just like today, we are here at Guilherme's house. We have barbecues, help each other, whether it is with training or some other problem. This is very important within this group. Wherever you see one Brazilian, you will see several. And whenever someone rides, there are five or six of us helping them get out of the chute.
It is a very important aspect of this group that we help each other find success.
Make it good. Make it good.
Just a small town girl.
Not bad.
She took the midnight train going.
That guy's in it.
Just a city boy. He took the midnight train going.
We're going to try something new tonight. We're cracking it out new. Mark, hit it. That's a first time. That you people are good.
Big and high, he's holding ill when he used to make it talk so tough.
Sorry, I got lost in my Bon Jovi.
No, we know.
Lost in. Oh! He's on a. We're still a commercial. I'm good. I'm taking over. Okay. You want to hear some of this, Clint? This is my only chance to be a rock star, right here.
It's all the same. Hell, and the names will change. Every day seems we're wasting away. Another play. Oh, where the faces are so cold. Drive all night just to get back home. Cause I'm a clown boy on a steel cage. I hide, want him dead or alive.
One more time, Rudy.
Want it dead or alive.
Back to you, Clint.
Folks, how about Flint Rasmussen? Make you feel a little bit better.
A little better? A little better?
He's already so high on himself.
Blow my whistle,
little,
baby.
Just a little disappointed he didn't get picked for America's Got Talent. Season 18. Renato Nunes, Brandon getting ready to go. The world champ. Jack Daniels shoot.
Yeah,
that's where we're at.
Look, this man, you know, we're talking about Renato Nunes. Fun guy to watch, especially whenever he's hitting on all cylinders, because he is a guy that will ham it up. His free arm gets to whipping around there, and I mean, he, you know, just wow. But it has been a very difficult season for Renato Nunes. Until, yeah. You know, you look at him, and I say that after even Renato is, by the way, coming off of last night's 88.5
right.
point bull ride.
Right. But, well, you know, top 10 finish, ninth is best so far this season. And once again, going to put the pressure on him tomorrow.
Right.
To get into the Built Ford Tough Championship round. By the way, 2 o'clock performance will crown a champion here tomorrow afternoon of the LiftMaster Invitational. As you watch it back, Renato Nunes, no score. So, Edivaldo da Silva. Brandon in the Stanley Buck and Shoot. Little Bear Creek Ranch. Cody Ole and Brashears bringing us this one.
I can't get these memories. So the man is Eduardo Aparicio.
Da Silva.
Yeah. That. From down in South America, yeah. A little Bear Creek Ranch.
I hadn't seen this bull before, making his debut on the PBR Built Ford Tough Series. I tried so hard to let you go. Coming up out of the minor leagues. Some kind of had the shot a couple of weeks ago, and Winston-Salem took full advantage of that at his first Built for Tough Series event. And he's got issues.
I got my first real six string, bought it at the Five and Dime. Played it till my fingers bled. Was a summer of 69. Me and some guys from school had a band and we tried real hard. Jimmy quit, Jody got married. Should've known we'd never get far. Oh, and I look back now, the summer seemed to last forever.
You scoping the house, are you? You on the prowl, are you? Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. We
kicking
know
it
you.
In. Kicking it 80s style right now.
Creepy old man.
Jesse is a friend.
Yeah. Eduardo ready to go.
You're unbelievable.
Yo.
It took him a little while, but when he got it done, he just sat in there and made it work.
Exactly. Nice. Awaiting his numbers coming in. 80 and a half. 80 and a half. Hey, by the way, Flint, listen.
Yeah.
We know what you were doing. I mean, you can't you can't pull the rug over our eyes.
What?
You're scanning the crowd. You're looking for the most elusive creature known to man.
I was.
The SoCal Cougar.
I was. There's cougars on the loose in Orange County. I've heard all about it. Let me tell you something. If you know every word to Jesse's girl, you're a
right.
cougar.
Exactly. Emilio Resende, Team Cooper Tires, ready to go. Whoa, hand popped out. And that got crazy
wow,
quick.
Wow, boy, he got really lucky right there. You see, he is. I want to wait and watch the replay back here one time and see if his spur hung in the rope or the flank. In the flank. And you see it come off. His. You see the heel of his boot and the spur hung in the flank rope right there as that bull came around and he pulled the flank off the bull. And
yeah.
Wow.
Tough right there. And he is on his way back to the locker room. And Brandon. Right now, buddy, I think we're going to go up to the big screen.
Here's this week's athlete profile brought to you by Cooper Tires.
To win a PBR.
A lot of PBR fans, they think that the Bloodlines is just for the bulls, and most of it is, but Bloodlines also run in the family, too.
JB's grandfather, we called him Catfish.
My father played professional baseball.
And it didn't matter if he's 20 runs ahead or 20 runs behind, he played the same way.
He played to win, he didn't play to lose.
He played up until he sprained his ankle real bad and started the issues with his legs. Lost one leg, which eliminated the playing days, and then lost his second leg.
At that time, a lot of people that lost their legs with injuries would just want to give up. They would quit. Catfish had no quit in him. He just kept going.
He never gave up playing baseball. When he couldn't actually run, he actually sat at home plate and hit the ball and would have a runner run for him. He just wanted to bat.
You know, I see old pictures and what my mom tells me, you know, both his legs was amputated and he was still baseball, doing all that with baseball and everything, never slowed him down.
He never did give up, just like JB. He's don't give up on that bull ride.
J.B. Mooney continues his attempt to ride with his opposite hand.
Anytime somebody tells me I can't do something, I'm going to try everything I can to do it. And I feel like that's the way he was, you know. I mean, a lot of people said, I guarantee a lot of people said he couldn't, you know, do a lot of things not having any legs, and he went right ahead and did it.
Look at that! He gets the ride, he gets the points, and he takes the hits.
For him, it was using his right hand. For my dad, it was how can I do that without legs?
He never let it slow him down. He kept right on getting it and doing what he was doing when he had two good legs. And I looked at it like, if he could do that, you know, I can do it. I can ride bulls right-handed.
His first qualified ride as a right-hander, and this is going on the highlight reel.
Toughness definitely runs in the bloodline of this family.
Me and my grandfather and me, We're gonna fight till the bitter end, whether it's my right hand, my left hand, we're here for the long haul.
Now that you've done that, now you can have your tools.
Wow.
That's right.
Did you see him look at the kid and be like, thanks, buddy? He looks at the kid and was like, yeah, thanks. Hey, appreciate
thanks.
That.
Thanks. You did your job for me, kid. It's like having a puppy.
Yep.
Stanley Tools, wherever you go, whatever you do, make something great right there. And our Stanley stud of the night. As round number two continues to the LiftMaster Invitational, and not a whole lot of movement at the top of the leaderboard. Luke Snyder still the number one man. And remember, championship round tomorrow. Guaranteed 10 riders, could be up to 15, depending on how many guys ride two throughout the weekend. And folks, we are about to jump quickly into the action in the Jack Daniels Buck and Shoot. And how many of you folks want to see Ben Jones dance here on a Saturday night? Dancing Aussie, taking that final wrap down in there, and little Whiteout, Cody Olin, the Cade family, and Ben Jones. It has been pretty quiet for him the first 5 weeks of the season. Broke out the dance last night. Round one, can he do it two nights in a row?
Every day I'm shuffling.
Go to it, Ben Jones! Yeah. 81.5 points, and Brandon, it's more than the numbers for Ben Jones. He's a guy that going into last weekend desperately needed points. He is here this weekend outside of the top 30. He needed this. He needed two in a row, and he got it.
He got two in a row. That's exactly right, because coming in now, that makes only five guys that have been able to do just that. That is ride a pair of them. And, you know, Ben Jones, man, the thing I like about that guy is every time he rides a bull and he gets 8 seconds, it's almost a feeling that he looks like he won the lottery. He's that excited about it. I mean, he's pumped up. Passionate bull rider.
And you know something else, when you talk about pressure being on these guys, remember we had the cut last week after the fifth event. There will be no more cuts. It will be a fluctuating top 35. So those guys that are inside the top 30, they're locked in.
Absolutely.
But if you're outside, I mean, your career, your weekend, week, you're riding, that's right, it's on the line. So big for Ben Jones. Let's go to Cody Nance. Paris, Tennessee, like the name of this one. That's what you need.
Snickers.
You need a Snicker. Snickers bar.
Yeah.
Right.
Crown 7 Bucking Bulls and Cody Nance of Paris, Tennessee. Get a hold, son. Trying to get it right in there. Look at Cody Nance trying to straighten that bull
there he
up.
Goes. That bull was leaning on him back there, and then he got right. So here we go.
Cody Nance, Paris, Tennessee. Gets through it 81.5. 81.5 for Cody Nance.
Well, at least it gets him on the board there. Nice, nicely done. Got to get the ones ridden that they give you. And so that's 11th qualified ride in this round. As he walks back to the locker room. We'll turn our attention to Jared Farley.
Yes.
Don't even do it.
Do it.
Time to take it to Australia.
Do it.
I can. I know you like that music, Flint. I know you like it.
Yeah.
Break it down, BT.
Jared Farley needed to get another one in. He was 81 and 3/4 points in an earlier round. That was last night. Yes!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Watch him, boys. Watch,
watch him.
Watch him. Got it.
Man, that is classic. And unfortunately, Jared Farley down in quick. Cindy Rosser, Flying Sea Livestock, bull and a no score for Jared Farley. So, not a whole lot has changed. Luke Snyder, Agnaldo Cardoza, number one and number two here in Anaheim.
Tonight's dose of adrenaline is courtesy of...
You know, when people think bucking bulls and ranches in general, they think of Texas, Oklahoma. Here we are in the foothills, the Appalachian Mountains, or the Blue Ridge Parkway, and you know, the only flat land we have is probably man-made. This was my great-grandfather's place here, so we're back home where it all started in the family, and we decided this is no better place than home to build a facility, and we tried to build this facility to accommodate some of the best bulls in the world.
The big bull and the little Brazilian.
Chicken on a Chain, he's by far the cornerstone of my program. Without him, I have, without a doubt, I wouldn't be where I'm at today.
Renato Nunez has combined with Chicken on a Chain, and these scores are gonna be big.
I'm not sure ranching or farming or bucking bulls is the best living in the world, but we sure think it's the best way of life, and we want to try to make our kids from the time they're little up to have a sense of value of that, and this is what Tucker gets to do on a daily basis.
It is what we do for a living, but it is our life. It encompasses all areas of life. From the minute you get up in the morning, you know, we know we've got all these animals, horses, bulls, cows, calves, everything. So we've got stuff to take care of. And we try to do it as a family. We involve all of our family as much as we can.
Go to Rango. He's probably our rankest bull we got going on the truck right now. I think he's the only bull we got that could be a serious title contender.
Dealt a blow by Rango.
For Gunpowder, he's a little more on the hard side to handle.
The money bull, Gunpowder led.
We want to try to make this facility as much as it would be like they're on the road. And everything is like a constant to them all the time. You know, they get fed the same time each morning and each night. They're penned the same way they would be on the road. So we try to keep everything as consistent here as we would on the road.
He's a quiet person. He's actually very shy. And he's always got his hat pulled down over his eyes. You know, he likes to be around his family, and he likes to be around his bulls and be at home.
Gives me an opportunity to spend a little time with her, catch up on what's going on in her life, and we get to work the bulls at the same time. So it's kind of a win-win situation for me.
He really enjoys his time with his family. He loves to just hang out. You know, let's go eat, let's just go all hang out, go to a movie, let's go get ice cream, let's do something as a family.
This is their project calf, so they feed her a couple times a day. Come here. Sometimes she gets a little rough on them, pops them in the nose, but it's all good at the end of the day.
Yeah, they're part of what we do every day. And we are a part of what Jeff does every day. So, that does make it a family business. You know, we're all a part of it.
You guys having fun on a Saturday night?
Here we go. Here we go.
Yo.
Ready? Mark, give it.
Yeah, I know it's hard to remember. But
There's a look at Billy Robinson, the 33-year-old down in there, the veteran on red carpet.
Come on, William.
Oh. And you see him, and Brandon, there was a guy that Dr. Tandy Freeman looked at before the performance. He took a shot last night, very sore. You saw him grab those ribs right there, and, I mean, he was in some pain before he got on that bull.
Bruised him up a bit last night, but, look. Yeah.
Look how slow he is getting out of the shoot.
It'll make it feel all better whenever you say 86 points, Billy Robinson. 86.
Nice.
Nicely done.
Oh, now. Got a little boom in my big truck. Gonna open up the doors.
Instead of stepping in, Reese Gates is the talent that we are looking at. El Dorado, Arkansas. Former Rookie of the Year of the PBR. Had a little bit of a rough sophomore season. Been battling it out down there on the Touring Pro Division, but now he's back.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
But a guy that had a big moment tonight, huge moment for Reese Gates. Last night, he was 87.5 points, and today, that was the bull, Lonesome Dove. Humps and horns, sis and stands, bucking bulls. That won the battle, but it could have been big time for him.
Are you ready for Guilherme marching? The world champ from 2008. Talk about the first 5 weeks of the season. There was some question marks that were popping up.
Big question marks.
Yeah.
Those first 4 weeks, he'll tell you, they were just not good. Just terrible.
Well, he answered all of those questions in Sacramento, California last weekend and bested them all.
We're going to see him not once tonight, but twice. Remember, he's going to be dealing with Sancho, the bonus bull, coming up a little bit later. Trying to gather the points, the money, the whole nine yards, and he is a man on a hot streak right now. Guilherme Marchi, ball peeing the bull from Jeff Robinson at Bar 3D, bucking bulls. He's already ridden one, was 84.25 last night. Let's go!
Up and Brandon, let's go back and look at this replay right here. I mean, this is why this guy's, you know, is a world champion. Look at this bull right here turn back into his hand, and Guilherme gets tipped off just a little bit on the inside of the spin. What does he do? He looks to the outside, opens up with that outside foot. That is just what he needed to make the 8 seconds and 84 points for Guilherme Marchi. 84, Brandon. He's got two in the books, and he's inside the top five.
There you go.
Exciting
there.
PBR action will be back in just a few moments. The Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation is dedicated to ensuring the future of elk, other wildlife.
This is my farm here in Brazil. I bought it with money that I won bull riding. Here we have Eduardo. He's 4 months old. And this is Janelle. She is 2 years old. Say hi. These are my two children. When I got married, I lived here for 9 months because I didn't have a place in the city. To my far left is my father. Then here is my grandfather. I am Silvano. And then here is my uncle.
We all are bull riders, but the only other one who was a professional bull rider was my father. He rode with Adriano. This is the first time I rode. I don't remember, I was 3 years old. It all started in 2004. There are many rodeos in here. Ever since I started riding, I would buy a photo at each rodeo. They are all in here, up until today. All the rodeos I rode in. All these are trophies that I won in bull ridings here in Brazil. I've got a lot of checks. I've won 24 motorcycles and 6 cars. They're all important because these are all the rodeos from around here. I won them all.
Silvano continues to show why he deserves that number one ranking.
My father taught me how to ride bulls. At first, he didn't like that I was riding because it is dangerous. No parent really wants their kids to ride bulls because of the danger.
Silvano Alves saves his best for last. Silvano Alves takes the gold buckle.
Being a world champion this season, it wasn't something I expected. It is very rewarding because everyone who dreams of being a bull rider, they dream of achieving this. My father told me congratulations and that he was proud of the path I was following, that I had managed to become a good bull rider. He congratulated me. Winning the championship and coming back to Brazil, it's bittersweet. It's always good here, visiting my house here, enjoying myself here with my family, traveling around this region and seeing friends. Things have changed for me here in Brazil and in the USA. Everybody wants to take pictures and be around me. The truth is that I feel a little embarrassed about the intention, but I do take pride in the fact that it affirms what I've accomplished in bull riding.
Years of thrills. 20 years of spills. 20 years of excitement that only the PBR could deliver. Come celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Professional Bull Riders as the Built Ford Tough Series returns to Sprint Center February 23rd and 24th for the Built Ford Tough Invitational. Presented by Ford F-150 with EcoBoost. Tickets start at just $10. Get them now at AXS.com. Buckle up, Kansas City.
Angels t-shirt.
20 years of...
Jim McLoy, congratulations, our Jack Daniels Fest winner. I want to say a big thanks to the good folks at Jack Daniels.
All right, do we tie them up right now? Go! It is my fate. Now, you are going to help with this. Clint?
What? I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
Bass Pro Shops, cash for cash. I'm sorry, are we going right now? Dickie's video? Upside, yeah. Upside to the big screen, a message from our friends at Dickie's. Thank you. All right, now we're going to go up top Bass Pro Shops, cash for cash. Here's the deal. Who we got up there? Katie and Samantha, right? Katie, Samantha, look, we're going to give you a chance right now to win $1,300. Do they know that? They know $1,300. $1,300 from our friends at Bass Pro Shops. Here's what you got to do. You got to get dressed in that camouflage when I say 1, 2, 3, go as fast as you can. Pick up the bow and arrow at your feet. The first one to hit that target down at the end gets $1,300 from our friends at Bass Pro Shops. Spending spree. The biggest prize in the history of the Bass Pro Shops, cash for cash. Are you ready? On your marks, big bucks for, yep. Your marks, get set, go. Get dressed. All right, here it is, $1,300. Wow, that was not good. She was close, though.
Wow.
$1,300. You got to hit
one
it
more.
Cleanly. Cleanly. If you don't, tomorrow it could go to $14. Last one right here. Look up top.
Are you serious? Yep. Can we go out there and do that?
Well, we can. I just don't know if they're going to give us a 1,400. Is it the 1,300? That's going to be 1,400 tomorrow.
14,
Bass
right.
Pro Shops. Big bucks for big bucks. Yeah.
All right. So back up to the big screen for this week's Built for Tough Clash of the Cowboys.
Thanks for joining us for another Built for Tough Clash of the Cowboys. Well, this week we have a paintball challenge. The objective is to hit this target, but the catch is two gunmen will be shooting at them to earn points back. Ready, set. All right, LJ is the first cowboy. Brendan and Robson shooting.
The guns were positioned at three of these stations.
Go, LJ, go, LJ. All right, he's got one. LJ's got another.
It was so fast-paced, you didn't have time to think.
Another one. It is just rapid fire with the bandits.
You got three balls on the target, so that's 5 points each, 15, but minus three for the three hits that you got from the bandits. So it is 12 altogether for the first one up for the Outlaws.
Ready, set. All right, Jesse.
For farther back, it's harder for them to shoot at you, so it gives you a little more time to get a sight on the target.
Oh, he's got two on the board! And another one, and another one! Then he's gonna dive into that safe zone.
So you got on the board seven times, and you have seven direct hits. So that is 28 altogether. Next up are the bandits.
Ready, set. Then we got Harv and Luke gunning them down.
Well, make sure you log on ClashOfTheCowboys.com. Tune in to see more action going on there from our friends at Ford. Also saying hello with us, our friends from Caterpillar. Glad to have our friends at Caterpillar with us. Tough, indestructible, and rugged are the same three words used to describe the best bull runners in the world. They also apply to Caterpillar equipment that makes every PBR event possible. For the most durable and productive equipment available, do what the PBR does and choose Quinn Cat. Visit the Cat booth on the concourse for your chance to win a brand new skid steer, trip to the PBR World Finals, and Cat sweatshirts. Thanks, our friends at Cat.
Down right, stupid, hot, hot. From the cross.
she can fly away. Oh, she got both feet on the ground, and she's burning it down. Oh, she got her head in the clouds, and she's not backing down. This girl is on fire.
Nothing else but you all night and day. It's like I got a first class seat up on Ozzy's train. It's driving me insane. 5150, somebody call the po-po. I'm going crazy thinking about you, baby. 5150, just a side of loco. I'm going crazy, think I love you, baby. Your number, girl, I gotta call you up. I gotta get you riding shotgun in my truck. This little bit of you I got, it ain't good enough. Yeah, you got me all messed up. 5150, somebody call the po-po. I'm going crazy thinking about you, baby. 5150, just a side of low. Crazy, think I love you, baby. Cause I ain't never felt like this. No. And I just need one kiss from you, and I'll be good as new. If I don't get some of your sweet loving, don't tell me. Call the po-po. Think I'm losing my mind, girl. 5150, just a side of loco. Yeah, 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 yeah. 5150, somebody call the po-po. I'm going crazy think about you, baby. 5150, spinning my head like a yo-yo. I'm going crazy.
Off. capture that last footage, please. Coming to you tonight. Of course, you look at your leaderboard, but hey, don't forget tomorrow afternoon, 2 o'clock, Championship Sunday, right here. If you haven't got your tickets, you don't want to miss this. Of course, big things happening tomorrow. The world champion Bucking Bull Asteroid will be here tomorrow, and boy, a big championship round we will have on hand. Once again, want to give a big shout out to all the folks watching on our PBR Live Event Center. We got a bunch of texts, a lot of tweets from our friends in North Dakota watching tonight. And boy,
every state, across the country. Tweets from Brazil.
Exactly. By the way, we also want to welcome the crew from the number one rated show in all of television, NCIS, is here with us tonight, guys. Special friends, there they are over there. Great partners and friends of the PBR, of course. NCIS, only on CBS, the official partner of the Professional Bull Riders. Let's go to Mike Lee, Decatur, Texas, the world champ.
Whoop.
And he's ready to go on curveball.
Gonna post him up in there a little bit. He's ridden this bull before.
And Mike Lee, was that a pink flank rope on the back of that bull? It was.
Yes.
Yeah. So, well, here you go, BT, right here. Break it down for me.
I can't. I don't. I got.
You got nothing.
Nothing.
Okay. I'll come back to you. So, Mr. Excitement, Jory Marcus. In the Jack Daniels Buck and Shoot and Ransom.
Boy, he is fired up now. Look at him.
Yeah. Wow. What a bull ride.
Pistol. What did you see? What's Jory? Well, say now. Say now. Go ahead, Jory. Show us that.
Jory,
go ahead,
Jory. Do it, Jory.
Go ahead, Jory. Right there, Jory. You were. Yeah.
Well, me not.
All right, Jory Marcus numbers 87.75 points. 87.75. And there, look back at your replay. And our safety man going to work. There we go. 87.75. Jory Marcus right there. And, boy, puts him number one. Now, that's in the round tonight. Remember, Luke Snyder in the lead of the event. But that's
right.
That's big. Nice ride by Jory Marcus.
Check this out. Say dog, Cypress Hill, yo. P.O.D. and they coming through. So you got any problems, forget about them.
Aaron Roy, the man to go, the Canadian talent, Black Duck, Ferguson Ranch. LiftMaster Buck and Shoot. We're looking at the LiftMaster Invitational. Working it out up in the front. Aaron Roy in there trying to get it right. Talk about a little bull with some heat. They open the LiftMaster. They open the LiftMaster shoot, and it is just Alabama left.
Oh, and similar situation to several of the guys tonight. Road one in round one came down in round two. So pressure on Aaron Roy tomorrow, championship Sunday, 2 o'clock. Is right now we have an opportunity, Flinto.
Clinto.
To say, yeah, buddy.
Congratulations? Is that what we're going to say?
Absolutely.
I anticipated. I jumped all over there.
Exactly. Let's Ron go. Kincaid, you are our area. Get your boots dirty winner.
Ron.
Hey, Ron.
Ron.
Good to
Ron.
See you, Ron.
Where is? Does it say where he's sitting?
No. Somewhere in San Diego.
Where you at, Ron?
No. Section 220. Section 220.
Ron.
Rod.
Is that you, Ron? Thanks for getting so excited. Appreciate that.
Keep it classy, Ron.
Keep it classy. Ron, are you paying attention?
No.
No. Made with bits of real panther.
Exactly.
It is
hey,
fun.
You know,
it
you
is.
Can, you can
know,
actually
I mean,
buy
but say,
that.
Like, when we come, like, when we're here, right? It is. It's just, it's extremely fun. It's tip, you know, we're it's lighthearted and we have a good time.
Right. The
it's
what
exactly? I was trying to add to what you were saying,
but you didn't.
You guys, look at—I mean, look at this arena. And by the way, I just got interviewed on TV for the telecast first time in 2 years.
We were watching you.
Yeah, Craig and I—we looked good on the kiss cam, didn't we?
Yep.
Blah.
And I hate to break this down to you, but that went on television too.
It did.
Yeah.
His wife is mad. You know what's cool about here, though? Like, here's what I want to do. Sometimes I feel, as much as I love the people down here, sometimes I feel that the rowdy, fun, really true fans sit up there. And I will say this to you in defense of these people. If you would buy your tickets sooner, cough up a little more money, you could sit down with these people. But, okay, watch. You ready? Okay, you people, shusha, ha. Shusha, no lady, shush. That's why you got kicked out of the third grade. Sit quietly. Just the people up there, watch how good these people up there. On three, ready? One, two, three, ready? No, what? You people again, follow directions, ready? Bottom two. Ready? Watch, Clint. Ready? Here's what we're going to do. We're going to make it more fun. We're going to pretend we're cowboys and do like everybody watching TV and cowboy shows thinks we say. What does everybody think we say? What do they say to us when we're on the street?
Yeehaw.
Yeehaw, cowboy. Yeah. Little tip. None of us actually say yeehaw until today. You people on the top, you're the yee, and we're a little more contemporary. It's yee, like, can a brother get a yee, yee? So you people on top, you're the yee. Ready? Bottom, guess what? You're the ha. Ready? One, two, three. Ready? Top.
Kind of faded in the stretcher a little bit.
Ready? I know. You make me wanna shout. Kick my heels up and shout. Throw my hands up and shout. Throw my head back and shout. Come on now. Don't forget to say you will. Don't forget to say yeah, 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 yeah. Say you will. Say it right now, baby. Say you will.
Moving up right now to go Douglas Duncan, Alvin, Texas.
The stud finder himself.
Yeah. Hey, ladies. Magic Dust, Diamond G. Miss Cindy Gilbert back there pulling the trigger on this bull. And Douglas Duncan set ready to go. Jack Daniels shoot, teeing it up, and the man's already got one in the bag. 86 and 3/4 points.
Oh, no. Dickie's Dura Bullfighter's in there. Yeah.
Hey, Frank, they're all over Frank tonight.
How about Frank Newsome, Shorty Gorham, and Jesse Byrne, our Dickie's Dura Bullfighters? And Brandon, that one went ugly quick. Good news is Douglas Duncan, who's been battling the hips, they've been a problem for him. He gets to walk out.
Yeah,
that's good. He looks all right.
For the past couple of days, his hips seem like they have not bothered him as much
and
here
that's good
at
news.
This event. That is very good
right.
news. You look at him right there. Magic Dust kind of double clutches on him, gets his heels clicked, flips him over the front end, and hangs him temporarily in the bull rope for the bullfighters to step in, do their thing, save him, and now he is headed back to the locker room.
So Sean Willingham getting ready to deal it up. What can we get done tonight for the 31-year-old? Big winner in Oklahoma City. Not the best weekend in Sacramento. And that's not eight.
No, and Sean Willingham hits the ground early right there, 7.14. He knows it, and yeah. Tough luck for the guy who came back really hot, won the event in Oklahoma City, got it done, had it going early on in Sacramento. Didn't finish that strong, but here he has struggled in SoCal.
Yeah, Dr. Feelgood, Cody Ole and Bad Company teaming up. No score for Sean Willingham. And there he is on his way back to the locker room, Brandon.
What? By the way, we're getting ready to go to Jordan Hub. I want to remind everybody, big bonus bull coming up
that's
tonight.
That's right.
Marchie right. going to be dealing up with the bull. We'll be watching Sancho a little later, but Jordan Hub right now. T-Rex, Certainty Ranch, and Rodeo. Jack Daniel's shoot. And Jordan trying to put it together.
Clock says eight and Jordan Hupp able to put his name in the hat for tomorrow, get into that long round, round number 380 and 3/4. You saw the bull cut out right there at the very end. Not the stereotypical trip for T-Rex tonight. Of course, the judges dock him for that 80 and 3/4 points. But nonetheless, Jordan Hupp on the board with 80 and 3/4. Luke Snyder is still the man on top of the leaderboard, 172 and 3/4.
Hey, this heart-stopping action is brought to you by Bass Pro Shops. For information regarding store locations and special events, visit BassPro.com. Big Tex, America's number one selling trailers. Check out the perfect tires for your vehicle at CooperTire.com. DeWalt Tools, guaranteed tough. Echo Chainsaws, built to handle even the toughest jobs.
Well, folks, take a look at your big screen. Let's get you set up for the Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation go-to guy.
Tough, fearless. Each week, the bullfighters put their lives on the line to protect the bull riders of the PBR. And Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation wants to reward their courageous acts with a hunting adventure they'll never forget.
Sports fans, you have a say in which bullfighter wins the RMEF Go-To Guy Award. Go to www.pbr.com/go-to-guy to vote for which Dickie's Dura bullfighter you think made the save of the week each week this season. Not only will the bullfighter win the trip of a lifetime, but one lucky fan will also win a hunting adventure, compliments of the Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation. Hunting is conservation. The Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation, ensuring the future of elk, other wildlife, their habitat, and our hunting heritage.
Well, folks, the Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation, log on 2 p.m. Monday each week. Vote for, as he just said, which of Dickie's Dura bullfighter you think made this weekend save of the week. Hey, you might be on your way to hunting trip with that guy, with you. You're the host of that show.
That's them. There you go.
Well, I know. But you're the host of the show.
Yeah.
So
good show
to
you,
by the way. Yeah, well, it is. Top-rated show. Log on pbr.com/go-to-guy. Must be 18 to win. No purchase necessary. Valid in the 50 United States. And there, a quick look, Brandon, the Jack Daniels average leaderboard. And not a lot of movement tonight, but Snyder's got to be happy where he is right now.
Nothing average.
Number one position.
Nothing average about that, I'll tell you that right now.
Oh, come on. Thank you.
Just throwing that out.
Appreciate it. That's why you're the best color man in
the
business.
I know.
That's right.
Luke is the one that it turned moving day into moving day. He is the guy that stepped up, got it done.
And by the way, speaking of things to do, and of course we got a lot left. Don't forget, if you want to meet Flint, you want to meet the Dickie's Dura Bullfighters, jersey 201, buy it, meet him,
sign it.
He'll kiss you.
Maybe, yeah, okay, whatever.
Yeah, no, it's going to happen.
I've done it before.
Photos,
drinks. Request. And then
food.
Tonight, we get a good night's rest. We come back here.
Right, 2 o'clock.
2 o'clock tomorrow. Finish
o'clock
it up.
Tomorrow.
Because we know Saturday's wild. We love Saturday, but the real, true, hardcore fans come out on Championship Sunday.
Right.
We know that.
Exactly. Sunday fun day.
Sunday fun day tomorrow, 2 o'clock. Bam!
Sunday. Every day.
Oh, come on, J.B. Mooney fans, where are you?
The day I was born, the nurses all gathered round.
Follow the lead of the people up top in 433. That's the deal. Yeah, we're watching. We're watching.
She could tell right away.
Don't weaken.
Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone.
J.B. Mooney trying to set up, ready to go.
Yeah, came down last night, round number one. You saw at the top of the show, got stepped on. Possibly sustained a broken bone in his leg, folks. Talked to JB. He said, you know what? More than likely, this thing's broken. Our PBR sports medicine team worked on him as best as they could. JB Mooney on Shameless is going to re-pull. But, Brandon, there is no other way than to say this. He is in a lot of pain. He's having a hard time walking around. What J.B. Mooney is doing tonight is cowboying up. And the Jack Daniels buck and shoot, and here he is.
Every time that bull moves a little bit in there, shifts his weight, does anything, it is painful for J.B. Mooney. See him being very gingerly inside of that chute. Here we go.
Boy, Brandon, he was just giving it everything that he got. I mean, there is no doubt about it. Folks, he needs a little bit of help. He needs some encouragement. And you see this bull just turning back right there to the left, bringing some gas, and JB just not able to keep up. But J.B. Mooney in a fight wants this world championship title, wants the $1 million. 44 3/4 points, the Pabst Blue Ribbon Bull score. And so far this weekend, unfortunately, J.B. Mooney shut out here tonight. And there's a shot.
A lot of pain.
Dr.
A lot of
Tandy
pain.
Freeman back there. And Brandon, we continue. Let's stay in Mooresville, North Carolina, will we? Let's go to brother-in-law, J.B. Mooney. Shane Proctor. Keeping it real. That's what we do every day. Circle T Ranch and Rodeo, and there is a look and a shot at Shane Proctor. There are the stats. It's Shane Proctor, and what a comeback it has been for him. You rewind all the way to, well, not last December, but the December before that. Broken arm. Brandon, he went back, rehabbed, and it took him a long time to get things put back together. But when he did, he's been spectacular.
This was a guy that had a top 10 season in the PBR, then went to the PRCA, the National Finals Rodeo, won a world title over there, broke his arm in the 10th round, and it did take a long time for him to come back from the injury. But you are exactly right. Nail on the head. You smacked it. When he came back and when he finally got it together, now he is eyeing the prize, and that is a gold buckle. Hey. Very much that caliber of athlete right now.
Folks, how about Shane Proctor? Brandon, let's take a look at this replay as we watch it back again. This is a perfect display of what we call dominating this bull. Look at this bull turn back into his hand. Shane Proctor opens up with the outside foot, gives him a couple of punches right there, and 87 3/4 points. They reward him 87 3/4, and guess who is the number one man at the LiftMaster Invitational? It is Shane Proctor, 173.5, and my, he is putting the heat on the world number one.
Look out. Because speaking of the world number one, here the man is. Jack Daniel's shooting, we're dealing up. Savano Alves, folks, remember, in just a little bit, we'll take a very short break, and I do mean a commercial break.
Right.
That short, like 2 minutes. And after we will see, after this ride, we will see the bonus bull matchup with Guilherme Marchi on the bull Sancho. You don't want to miss that.
But Silvano Alves, the two-time world champ, the man that sits in number one right now this season. And he bucked off last night. Feel more trouble.
All right, so this one went to the whistle, and then a review was indicated by the official. So they're going to review this for a possibility of slapping the bull with his free arm. That is what I'm being told now. Did he touch the bull with his free arm at any point in time? During.
If it happened, I mean, I think it might have happened early in this ride.
Well, early or late, if it happened,
right.
It happened.
So we'll see here. Here's a look. All right, and watching and waiting for the decision to come in. And Brandon, I mean, this is very important for several different reasons for Silvano, obviously being the number one man. And that
green light, he gets a score.
Okay.
He gets a score. Did not touch the ball with his free arm. Got close. He got, I'm not saying
close
he wasn't close.
Count, I know.
I'm not saying he wasn't close.
That's right.
But he didn't touch him.
So numbers come in to make it official. Silvano Alves, 81 and a quarter points. 81 and a quarter. There you go. Silvano's happy. Nicely done.
Nicely done.
We go downstairs.
To our colleague on the floor.
And friend.
Our final commercial break of the night before the big show. What do we call it?
Huh?
The big money.
PBR bonus bull.
Bonus bull. Guilherme Margie coming up.
Right.
Before we call it a night. You know that every night, every city, I never miss a night. I never miss a stop. I pick, I honor, I award my Cooper Tires. Clint, as usual,
hey.
My what? Cooper Tires.
Fan
of the night. I would like to compliment the fans of Southern California on a Saturday night. You people are wonderful. I'm not going to lie, I went shopping today. I don't like your high sales tax, but I love you people. Much as I paid in sales tax today, I can't believe you people can't pay some things off down here. Tonight, nice. Though, don't get me started. But tonight, there's lots of nominees. Lots of nominees. First of all, my first nominees, all the girls in the suite up there, but then the people say, oh, he always picks the women. Blah, blah, blah. Tonight, I think to me it's a no-brainer. There's only one man that has not quit. Well, I don't know if it's a man or not. I'll be honest with you. Apparently, I left my shadow in Sacramento last week, and he followed me here. Only one man has worn a suit, a full body, what would you call that, a unitard? Is that a unitard? Come down here. I can't get you on the camera up there. Can you come down here? I'm going to do something I've never done before. Hurry, run down the stair. He's tired. Come down here. Here, come down here. Come down here. I want you to come right here. I never let people out here, but come right here. Here, let him in. Come here. You know, go ahead. This is the first time that I'm letting the fan of the night in the arena with. Come here. Come here. Okay, come here. So what do you got? You made a sign. Did you draw that? No, he didn't draw it. Look at it. That's me. Look at it. How cool is that? So listen, this year, our friends at Cooper Tires and Montana Silversmiths, for the fan of the night, this beautiful Montana Silversmiths, Cooper Tire, PBR fan of the night buckle. So I got to ask. What's your name?
My name's Gabby.
What is it?
Gabby.
Gabby? Yeah. Okay, here's the deal. Can we see what you look like or no? Do you want me to unzip you?
Uh-oh. Can't get the suit off. Going to be there a while.
Uh-oh. Here, you want some help? Don't think I haven't done this before. Hello. You good? Gabby, are you sweating under there? Okay, here we go. You ready? Yeah, that's my man right there. Listen, you were in Sacramento last week? You did. He told me happy birthday. Okay, listen. You're my fan tonight. You've been kicking it hard. Your man up there in the other suit, he weakened, took his hood off. No winner. You're the winner. My man Gabby, my shadow, Cooper Tires, fan of the night.
Congratulations, our Cooper Tires, fan of the night.
Well, it is that time, and it is at hand. The bonus matchup of the night, last week's event winner, Guilherme Marchi, trying to pick up a little extra cash in the points. If he rides this bull, it's worth 100 points free and clear, plus the ride score. That's a big deal. Thank you. You were looking at a man inside of that Las Vegas chute that throughout his career has amassed nearly, well, not nearly, let's just say he's nearing the $5 million mark, over four plus. He is a world champion. Four times he has finished runner-up to the world title. And undoubtedly will go down in this sport as one of the all-time greats. Guilherme Marchi back on track. He won Sacramento, did it in perfect fashion, and he is loving California.
California, you ready? Is a bull that he had been on twice before, and both times he has ridden that bull. Not tonight. Wow, that means the Monster Energy Money Bull tomorrow. Asteroid will be worth $44,000 in the championship round, and an opportunity to say thank you to our PBR Built Four Tough Series safety man from Oakdale, California, Mr. Julio Marino. Your Dickies Dura Bullfighters, Jesse Byrne, Frank Newsom, Shorty Gorham, Commander Cooper, Flint Rasmussen. Thank you, guys. And, of course, tonight, Jory Marcus coming out, putting his name on top of this round. And we'll pick up some bonus points in the round and a hefty paycheck for his ride in round number two of the LiftMaster Invitational. And there he is. And here we go right now. Oh, Shane Proctor, by the way. Jory Marcus splitting the round. And here in just a couple of moments, they will make their walk. And here they come. Great night of bull riding. Mr. Excitement, Jory Marcus. And a man that's been Mr. Consistency, Shane Proctor, Jory Marcus, your round winners of round number two. Oh, there it is. And once again, of course, don't forget, folks, our PBR stars are going to be coming out right now to sign autographs for you down here. We appreciate you for being a part of the Professional Bull Riders Built for Tough Series. Don't forget, tomorrow afternoon, 2 o'clock, it is Championship Sunday, and we'll crown a champion. And then, of course, don't forget the Monster Energy Money Bull coming to you tomorrow, and it is going to be for a Ford truck full of money. Folks, thank you so much for coming out to the PBR. For more information, make sure that you check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and, of course, subscribe to our YouTube page and log on to PBR.com. Have a safe trip home. We'll see you tomorrow.